Still see it's a WDSU first warning weather alert day. At times it's felt up to 116. Lakefront Airport looking at you. That's because dew points reached well into the 80s. 80, 81, 82, just terrible. But we start with WDSU first warning weather Doppler radar because the heat is coming to an end. Courtesy of these storms. Got a few pop up ahead of the main round. Had some isolated showers and storms earlier in the day. Out ahead of this main round of storms from Lafitte to Jean Lafitte, south of Crown Point. Got some hefty storms here, but when you look back out a little farther, you get some storms that are into coastal Mississippi and Pearl River, Hancock County, Mississippi. From Poplarville to the Kill Bay, St. Louis, Waveland got a storm, but the heftiest storms now are actually on their way into the greater New Orleans area. In the east part of it, New Orleans East, you're going to find these here before too long. Going to zoom out a little bit farther because I had this system moving at about 17 miles per hour. We're going to put this on the rain-cooled air, the kind of miniature cold front, if you will. Outflow boundary is the other name for it. Here's the arrival time of that outflow boundary that could create and blossom more storms, as it's doing right now as it moves into Lake Bourne. Looking for the greater New Orleans area, possibly as early as about maybe even 7:30. You can see Chalmette here at 7:30, and then from there you go on to Audubon by about 8 o'clock. So that is where we stand at this point. And we could have some storms even a little bit earlier with another outflow boundary. That was from the Jean Lafitte storms moving north. So the key point is here over the next hour to 2 hours, we've got a shot of those storms moving our way. But it's about the temperatures. You can see we've got 90s still out. Dew point of 81, I just said that, at Lakefront, feeling like 111. So the extreme heat warning, heat advisory for the next at least 43 minutes. It's still going to be really hot. Those that are more south and west that aren't getting the storms first. But the focus here will be the tropics to where we begin. First wave of storms with tropical humidity plume and extends all the way back to even in the Caribbean here in Cuba and even going to parts of the Bahamas. Water temperatures conducive for development. Plume of tropical humidity will stay around to give us that chance of development. The wind shear surrounding storms are very low as that bubble of heat's right on us. That's high pressure. That's a lack of winds and a lack of wind shear. So here's the deal with that plume of tropical humidity, a system up a few miles into the air. We're watching that there's a chance of that development at sea level, and that's where you could start to get some organization and strengthening, and then you become a tropical system. The chance is very low. The high-risk forecast we get into Thursday afternoon, I just see a broad area of possible spin coming at ground level. A lot of that is associated with the parent system that lives a few miles into the air. The system the National Hurricane Center has identified more into Florida, I just don't find anything gathering, strengthening, and by Saturday it's all over. It's going to be in at least Texas or possibly Mexico, so only 2 days of possible formation here. We will have scattered storms. The timing shows there first 8 o'clock. Scattered storms throughout the day Thursday, and even with this system and that plume of tropical humidity, we could even have overnight storms. So beginning now, all the way through Friday, extending into Saturday, you should have the rain gear with you. You should expect storms at times, especially daytime driven. The rain is likely over the next 2 days, but that's going to keep the heat at bay. National Hurricane Center update has just come in. I'm going to see if they still keep it at a 10% chance, but the reconfiguration now that has moved into just off the Big Bend of Florida means their 7 o'clock updates are early, so I'm going to check on that. Very low formation potential, but we know numerous storms will happen that I just showed, and that will break the heat. Now, still steamy to get up and going here on Thursday morning, but top temps only around 90, give or take. A low risk of locally heavy rain and possible flooding here into Thursday. Training camp forecast, it could rain, it could storm. Unfortunately, you have tickets for that. That means then things would have to move indoors and you can't watch the rest of it. We'll have more on that forecast coming up with the Saints special right after our newscast. WDSU first warning weather, 7 day, at least we don't have extreme heat, but stormy days before, well, rain ends at the end of the weekend next week and the heat's right back.